Dear students, let's begin the new topic of laws of thermodynamics, which starts with the concept of thermal equilibrium. I hope all of you are aware about the concept of thermal equilibrium. When there are two bodies, say these are at different temperature, one is at 20 degrees centigrade, other is at 80 degrees centigrade. And say their mass and specific heat are m1 s1 and m2 s2 respectively. If the two bodies are connected by a thermally conducting media, then heat flow will take place from high temperature body to low temperature body. Say this heat Q flows. It will flow until the temperature of the two will be equal. Say for example, after exchange of heat, the equilibrium temperature of the system, say it approaches to 50 degrees centigrade. And we can say this equilibrium temperature, and when the temperature of the two bodies will become equal, no net flow of heat takes place between the two, as two bodies at same temperature never exchange heat with each other. This is the situation we call thermal equilibrium. I hope all of you have studied it in previous classes or in early chapters. So this is the concept of thermal equilibrium, which we call when the bodies are at same temperature, these are said to be in thermal equilibrium. Now, based on the concept of thermal equilibrium, the very first analysis related to thermodynamics is done, that is under zeroth law of thermodynamics. This is called zeroth law because it forms the basis of first and second law of thermodynamics. Till now even third law is also evolved, but in this particular section we'll limit ourselves up to first law and second law of thermodynamics. So when we talk about zeroth law of thermodynamics, it is basically analyzing thermal equilibrium between different bodies. Say for example, I take three bodies A, B and C. Say if I connect A and B and we observe no flow of heat takes place, that means A and B are in thermal equilibrium. And say B is independently connected to C and it is also observed that no heat flow takes place between B and C, then we can say B is in thermal equilibrium with C. So we can state here, if a body B is independently in thermal equilibrium with two other bodies, then if we connect these two bodies, then obviously as being at same temperature, no net flow of the heat takes place between the two. So we can state these two independent bodies will also be in thermal equilibrium when connected independently. So this zeroth law of thermodynamics can be stated as, if A and B are in thermal equilibrium and we say B and C are in thermal equilibrium, this implies A and C will also be in thermal equilibrium. So it is just an obvious phenomena which you can understand. If A and B are at same temperature, B and C are at same temperature, then obviously when we connect A and C, being at same temperature, no net heat flow takes place between the two. This is the phenomena we call zeroth law of thermodynamics.